still crediting me because I'm still procrastinating it. Okay. Hi everybody, welcome back to the Antisocial Planet. I'm assuming back because why would you be starting with the 7th episode? Of course, maybe the 7th episode is your favorite and you're just starting there because why not? I'm just gonna leave it. So today we are going to be watching the 7th episode of Bleach. Now last episode we had some good laughs. We were introduced to mod souls, one of which is currently walking around with Ichigo's body, which is worrisome, and much to my stress and disappointment, we ended the last episode with Ichigo in spirit form going up against Ichigo in possessed form, and then the episode just kind of ended and left me there. So today we're finally gonna see what happens with that, and I'm not stressed out, you're stressed out. Also, in the last episode, I mentioned how I was so excited that we were 10 plus subscribers, and I guess you guys took that as some kind of challenge because I've gotten a bunch of new subscribers since then too. We're almost past 20, so thank you guys so much. I honestly don't know what to do with the support and interest that people keep having for this channel, but it makes my heart warm. Which is nice because it is so cold today. It is so cold that it has taken me forever to just like get up out of my comfy clothes. So thank you for bringing some warmth. Also, just a quick question before we get into the actual episode. I know that there are movies for Bleach. I don't know how they fit in. So I don't know if they're important to the story, and if I should be aware of when to watch those, or if they're just sort of supplementary stories, in which case do you guys want me to watch them and put up a reaction about it? And if so, when should I do that? I don't know if there are any OVAs, but if there are, let me know. And if they're also important, because I know it can kind of go either way with OVAs, they're either like slapstick funny things or they're like actually important to the plot. So I didn't want to look it up. I like started looking it up and then the internet was like, but how about some spoilers? And I was like, no, wait. So if you guys could give me some kind of context for how that all fits in, without spoiling anything obviously, I'd really appreciate it. As always, I won't be showing any actual footage of the episodes. I'll put a timestamp up in the corner so that you guys can follow along with me. Do I still need to be giving that speech? Do you guys need me to explain how this works? Because I feel like I keep, at the beginning of these episodes, being like, hi, I'm Sarah. Here's how the channel works. But like, we're on episode 7, so like, at what point can I assume that you've already watched previous episodes? Because I feel like if we get to like episode 50 of Bleach and I'm still like, hey, this is how it's gonna work, you're gonna be like, yeah, we know, Sarah. We've been here for the last 49 episodes. So, am I procrastinating because I'm a little bit stressed out and I don't trust the show to like give me answers by the end of this episode? Maybe. Let's just do it. In 3, 2, 1, go. We're gonna get to hear our music first, so I can still kind of take some deep breaths, center myself, find a way to be okay with the fact that this is probably gonna stress me out a lot. We also met a bunch of new characters last episode, which I have been told that the striped hat guy whose name escapes me now, I'm gonna have to like put up a board or something that's like all the characters and their names because I'm not gonna remember them all. But I've been told that the guy with the striped hat is a bit of a fan favorite, so I should kind of keep an eye on him. I don't know if that guy, I don't know if that's in a good way that he's super popular, or if it's in a love to hate kind of thing. Oh, in the preview for the last episode, we got a clip of the lion, right? The stuffed toy. Am I finally gonna get answers? I feel like I've been like hyping this up for myself, and it's gonna be something like really unimpressive, and I'm just gonna be like, oh. Well, maybe we'll find out. We'll find out eventually. Oh my gosh, you guys said that like the first 15 episodes are kind of like introductions, and we're like almost 10 episodes in. I don't know if I'm ready for things to like go down yet. Okay. Yes, I remember. Yes, the battle souls. Urahara. That's, yeah, him. The guy with the striped hat. Ugh. That little girl breaks my heart. She just seems so sad, and I just want to give her a hug. Yeah. Comfort her. Oh, see, someone gave her a hug. Okay. I think I like him. Anyone who shows compassion to like sweet, cute characters, I'm just like big softies, totally up my alley. See the line? Ooh, they changed it so the line's there. Right, we were protecting the nerds. This must again look really weird from the outside. Just like some guy randomly fighting with himself, being thrown around. His reputation is gonna be completely ruined, huh? Yeah, see, he. But though, well, I'd say he probably doesn't have a gender. But, the mod souls are like built to fight hollows. So, like, is that a instinct thing that they have? Or is it like a. Like, how much choice do they have at that? Sense it, Ichigo. Don't you have like some crazy sense powers? Oh, this probably looks crazy from the outside. Definitely. Just like screaming and fighting at nothing. Oof. I told you to be careful with Ichigo's body because it's not yours. Rukia doesn't have her healing powers anymore. I suppose Ichigo probably has some healing powers on account of being a soul reaper. I don't know, he's pretty strong. I think he can probably do this if he can, like, focus. I just love the two Ichigos like bickering and being like, "Excuse us, Hollow, we're in the middle of something." Boy, you better have a landing plan. That's what I'm saying. Ooh. Quite a cane. Guess Ichigo has never seen them before. Like, he doesn't know who they are. So are they gonna keep the spirit? The mod? What are they gonna do with it? Let it have Ichigo's body when he needs to be, you know, fighting Hollows? Have two Ichigos? See, that's what I've been saying this whole time, Rukia. It looks weird from the outside. Is that what the lion thing is? The idea of putting like a powerful, like warrior style spirit into a stuffed animal. Oh gosh. I was wrong. This is everything and more than I could have wished for. Just like wiggling out of his clothes to change. What is it? What was it? What happened? She's a good drawer too. Ugh, I knew I liked her. Made herself a robot. Moody character in glasses, doing some cross stitch. Is it an anniversary of some kind? Oh, nice shirt, Father. Like frills. Is it about his mom? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Are we gonna get that kind of backstory? I didn't bring my tissues this time. I don't know if I can take learning about the murder of his mom. Hi again. My camera turned off partway through that. I don't know why. Sometimes it's okay, sometimes it isn't. I'm at 20 minutes, 12 seconds. We're literally almost done. So sorry about that. That's why we have a time stamp. So let's just continue. We were getting into some really intense stuff, so I guess I could take a little bit of a break. Three, two, one. Here we go again. Hey, look, it's almost Beyblades. Why does it feel like there's a time shift between the clothing and the like weird saturation difference? Who are they, and what do they know about Rukia? Are they also soul reapers? They look kind of like they might be going after my Rukia. Okay. We were literally so close to the end, and then my camera was like, not today. So we're gonna get into some really heavy stuff next episode, huh? With a murder, maybe we'll get the full story of what happened to Ichigo's mom. Maybe it'll just be grieving and dealing with that. Either way, I don't think it's gonna be a fun time. We finally got to meet the lion stuffed animal, which is just amazing. I love that they've kept the mod spirit and they're just like, you live in a stuffed animal now. Okay, let's get our preview. Yeah, like it feels like it might be a little bit of a fun episode. Like it's overcompensating the fact that Ichigo and his family are grieving, so they're like trying to make the day really fun so that they can kind of move past their grief and feel something other than grief for a little while. We've been introduced to maybe some other Soul Reapers that are coming to collect Rukia, who's been in the human world too long. Maybe that's affecting her powers somehow. I don't really know how the power set works. Like, I don't know exactly like what the limitations are and like how much power she needs to go back, because I know that she talked about in this episode, the body that she has right now isn't really her body. Okay. My camera is being really weird today, so I'm gonna make this really quick and say thank you guys for watching. Obviously gonna get into some heavier stuff in the next episode, and I'm gonna be putting that out tomorrow because we're entering another lockdown where I am. So for the next 4 weeks, I'm gonna have a lot of free time, and I'm just gonna sit around and wanna watch anime anyway. So we're gonna get through some episodes of Bleach and Ergo Proxy and a bunch of other shows that have been suggested, so look forward to all that, okay? Before my camera turns off again. Bye!